hell out of here. I need to get some shelter from the heat stroke that's going on. It's like the exact opposite of a movie called The Hateful Eight, which I am also reviewing right now. Hateful Eight is the eighth film from director Quentin Tarantino, who I am a big fan of. In fact, I'm wearing his first movie on my shirt right now. It stars Kurt Russell, Samuel L. Jackson, Jennifer Jason Leigh, Michael Madsen, Tim Roth, Walton Goggins, Damian Bashir, Bruce Dern, James Parks, and many other actors, including Channing Tatum. The first eight there that I mentioned are the Hateful Eight. There are eight people who get stuck in a haberdashery, although there are actually nine of them. Nine people who get stuck in a haberdashery during a frightful blizzard in the middle of Wyoming about a decade after the Civil War. So obviously it's a very intense film. Well, tense. I wouldn't say intense, but it's a very tense film. Lots of tension between characters, especially considering some characters are from one side of the Civil War and other characters are from the other side. There's a lot of racial tension as well, and all in all, it's a very tense film, which is, kind of awesome considering that most of the film is actually dialogue with a few short bursts of very gory action. My friend Ben and I got the chance to see this movie in glorious 70mm. As advertised, it is in fact glorious. So this is the first movie in about 50 years that has been shot and projected the same way that this movie is being shot and projected. On a limited release, that is, though. Projected on 70mm film for limited release in only a few cinemas in the entire country, both Australia, America, Canada. So as you can see, this is a big event, and you can kind of see why I wanted to go see the movie in 70mm. And I can say that it was absolutely worth it. The film is absolutely gorgeous. Just almost every shot in this movie is just meticulously crafted and framed, and the movie is gorgeous. Literally the first couple of scenes are just shots of the landscape, and then the first long take lasts about maybe 5 minutes, and it's just a slow zoom out of a big statue of Jesus as a horse carriage goes past in a big snow-ridden landscape. And it's very wide as well to get a wider, more crisp, beautiful picture. Now the film itself is fantastic. The dialogue, as expected, is very incredibly well written, and so is the story. It's a mystery movie. Since it was about 3 hours, not including the 12-minute intermission and 6-minute overture, it's a very slow burner, but very well worth it. This also marks the first time that Quentin Tarantino is using an original soundtrack. I know that there are times where in maybe Kill Bill or Django Unchained where he had, you know, songs or something written, but this is the first time the movie's actually getting an original soundtrack composed specifically for the film, and it is magnificent. It's a great soundtrack that perfectly suits the movie. Well done, Ennio Morricone, however you pronounce his name. All of the performances are great, probably a career best for Channing Tatum. Channing Tatum was absolutely great in this movie, because normally he plays the lovable, romantic, or heroic character, but he plays a villain in this movie, and it's great. He has a little mustache, and his death, and that's not really a spoiler considering it's a Tarantino film, almost everyone dies in all of his films. His death is quite glorious. As is many other people's deaths as well. Gory and glorious. People have been complaining about the violence against the main and almost only female character in this movie, and I have to say that if this character were male, literally no one would have any complaints about this character being elbowed in the face or punched or kicked or anything like that. But because it's a female character, people are saying, oh no, she's got boobs, she can't be hit like that. And she definitely deserves it. I mean, she's not an innocent character. In fact, she is kind of a villain, so... But even then, I mean, if she's a fantastic character, with a fantastic performance from Jennifer Jason Leigh, and I thought she was hilarious at times as well. As with most characters in a Tarantino movie, it's hard to love them, but it's even harder to hate them, because they've all got certain qualities that make them, you know, characters. This movie is ultimately a tale of snow, racism and violence, and also betrayal and mystery and blood. And I highly recommend this whole experience. I mean, it's not in 70mm for a very long time. I think it's only out until the 20th. So yeah, you better catch those tickets quickly. But even then, I mean, the movie still comes out for general release on digital projectors all over Australia on the 21st. But I highly recommend going to see The Hateful Eight when it comes out, or in 70mm if you're really up for it. But honestly, this whole movie is just fantastic. It's glorious, it's beautiful, and it's gory. And I give it a 10 out of 10. Leave your thoughts about what you thought of The Hateful Eight, if you've seen it, in the comment section below, and I will see you next episode of whatever it is that I decide to make. Bye!